Hello everyone, welcome to Puzzle Bee 2021, India's biggest puzzle competition. This video will quickly explain how exactly you can register for this competition. All you need to do is visit the website www.puzzlebee.in. On the home page, you will see this button, click here to register. So just simply click on this button. So once you click on the button, you will be taken to this registration form. You need to quickly fill out a few details here. First of all, you need to enter a username. This username can be something of your choice. Right now, I'm just going with a dummy ID, puzzlebee2021. Preferably, you know, we would really recommend if you can have a username which is a combination of your first name, last name. But in case of certain names which are very common, that could be a problem. So you might just add some numbers or special characters there. Now your first name and last name have to be exactly the way they appear in any of your valid identification cards. This is something which would be required should you qualify for the semi-final and final rounds. So we would be having a verification process before the round begins. So you would need to validate whether, you know, your name and the other details that you have provided are correct or not. So kindly ensure that you do not write any funny names here. Okay, so please no Hulk and Superman and those kinds of names here. So right now, you know, I'm just writing Puzzle and B, but please write your own names. Now coming to email address, please provide a valid email address, because in case you forget your password for this account, you would need to reset the password, and the link to resetting your password would go on this email address. Now if you enter a dummy email address, the email would go nowhere and there's no way you can retrieve your account. So please ensure that you enter a valid email address. If the participant does not have an email address of his or her own, you can by all means use your parents' email address. Now, same thing for the mobile number. Please ensure you're writing the valid mobile number here. We might need to contact you in case you make it to the semi-final and final rounds. So please ensure that you have written the correct mobile number here. Now please select the class in which you are currently, okay, this academic year. So right now I'm going to go with class 1. So remember, the categories are based on these classes. So class 1 and 2 is category A, 3 and 4 is category B, and so on. So the test that would appear for you would change based on what class you are mentioning here. So kindly write the, you know, kindly select the appropriate class here. Otherwise, you might end up solving the test for some other category and you might end up being disqualified in such a case. Then comes the password. Now your password has to be minimum 8 characters long. It should contain at least one uppercase letter, one lowercase letter, and one number. You may or may not have some special characters. And enter the same one in the confirm password field as well. And then finally, you also need to write your school and city. Now, in case your school has multiple branches within the city, it would be advisable that you write the branch name as well. This is again important for the verification process that would happen before the semi-final round. Alright, so once you have entered all the details, you just need to click on the register button. Alright, so once you have registered, you will see this page. Now, remember, the same page will appear if you do not want to take the test right now and you log out. So later you can just go to this website again, www.puzzlebee.in, and on top right you will see a login button. Right now you see a logout button because I am still logged in because I just registered. Now if you have logged out, later you can simply click on login button and log in with the username or email address that you had entered and the password that you just created. Now, once you click on this click here button, it will take you to the next page which has the links for all the sample puzzles and the rounds. Okay, so round 1 is opened the 20th of October. You can take this as many times as you want, but round 2 onwards, only one attempt would be allowed. So we'll be sharing more details on round 2, 3, 4 later on. But for now, we can just focus on round 1. So you can click here on this link and check all the sample puzzles. You can click on the round 1 test and take the test. Now, we would strongly recommend that you take the test from a laptop or a desktop. Okay, there are certain questions which would not be very user friendly on a mobile phone. While we can still answer them, but you know, it would be easier for you if you have a bigger screen. Okay, so if you can do it from a laptop or a desktop or maybe even a tablet, that would definitely work better. But in case you do not have any such devices, even a mobile would work fine. So it's not that you cannot take it from a mobile, but if you have the option available, if you can take it from a laptop or a desktop, please use a laptop or a desktop only. Now let me show you how you can exactly take the round 1 test and generate your certificate. So I just clicked on that button, click here to take round 1 test, and it will take you to this next page where you just need to click here again. Now this page has all the instructions for the round 1 test. So remember, you can take the round 1 test as many times as you want. Your best score will be considered for round 2. So suppose you got 60% in your first attempt, then you tried to take the test one more time, but the second time you got only 40%. So do not worry, it's not the 40%, it's the 60% which would be considered as your final score. Okay, so the qualification for round 2 is a score of minimum 50% in round 1 test. So since you get 60, you will be able to register for round 2. Now, also let's talk about the other case. What happens if you get 40% in your first attempt, then you take it again and then you get 60%. So even in that case, you are eligible to register for round 2 because you have one score which is more than 50%. Now, to take the round 1 test, you'll have to click on this button. So when you click on this button, it will take you to a new tab. Okay, so this is how the actual test would look like. You'll have to click on either this play button or the next button. It will take you to the next slide where you'll need to enter your full name and email address one more time. That, remember, that again is just for the verification purpose. And once you're done with this test, okay, so right now I'm not going to take the test here. So let's assume I've finished the test. So after I've done that, I have to go back to this tab. Okay, so whether you are using a laptop, desktop or a mobile, the test will open in a new tab. Okay, so once the test is done, you can close that tab. Okay, if you close it midway, your test will not get submitted. So remember, you should close the tab only once you see your score on the final screen there. Okay, so once you have done that, you can come back to this screen and click on this mark complete button. Okay, so once I click on the mark complete button, it now shows that I have completed this test. Okay, so the green tick indicates you have completed this. Okay, plus what you also see here is you have earned a certificate. Now you can download your certificate by clicking on this download certificate button. Now remember, I had written my name as Puzzle B for this test user, so that's why this certificate got generated with the name Puzzle B. So for you, your first name and last name would be displayed here. Okay, so that's how you can download your certificate. Okay, so there's this download button. Okay, so in certain devices, this might get downloaded directly. In some cases, you will have to click on this download button in the browser. Okay, so that is how you get the participation certificate for round 1. Right, so that's it from our end. If you have any other queries, you can just drop us a WhatsApp message at 844-698-0747, or you can drop us an email on learn@logicology.in, or you can even write a comment on this video here. So that's it then. Wish you all the very best for Puzzle B 2021. We hope you have a great time. Please do share us your feedback. Thank you.